Hey, thank you guys for coming to my channel. Love you so much for coming over here to check me out. I'm your host, Brandy, and I'm here to give you a review on The Real Housewives of the Potomac Season 3, Episode 2. Now, this whole episode, I didn't get to review Episode 1, but it wasn't really giving me much to talk about anyway, I wasn't really feeling the premiere. I wasn't feeling it at all. But it's episode 2. Karen goes over to Monique's house, in a brand new car, honey, a brand new Jaguar. Monique is surprised, She's like, Karen came over here and a what? She's supposed to be going through some tax debt or whatever, her husband is $4 million in debt or something like that. And Karen comes over here in a brand new Jaguar, which causes just about $100,000. See, everybody's like, what? Monique is like, what? Karen did what? Karen is really surprised, so she comes outside and meets Karen in the driveway with the champagne in hand, and she's like, girl, I was gonna wait till you get inside, but I saw you pull up here in this brand new Jaguar, and I had to come outside because we gotta just toast to this, okay? She's telling her whatever, Then they get inside the house, and Karen's looking at the fish tank, and she got some sharks in there, and she's like, oh, I named them, and this one right here, I named her after you. This is the grand dame and what's not. And she's like, she pushed everybody out of the way, she eats first, and whatever, kissing Karen's ass, because that's what I see there. It's like, whatever, girl. Then they get into talking about the issue, and the issue of Karen Owen, being in tax debt, okay? She owes Uncle Sam, okay? And she's denying it. She's saying it's her husband who owes Uncle Sam and what's not. So they get into talking about this, and Monique basically asks her, how are you able to just push through this and what's not? And Karen, Monique was being very supportive. She made me see the difference between the way in which Robin handled the situation last week. Because last week, when I watched last week's episode, I was like, oh, Karen is being very defensive. But here you saw the difference. Here you saw the difference. I wasn't mad with Robin last week, but this week I saw the difference, and I saw what Robin was trying to do. Because Monique really sounded like a friend. She really sounded like a friend who is concerned for a friend. Unlike, how Robin sounded last week, She was like, she didn't judge her. She didn't do anything of the sort. And I totally could have seen with Karen, as to what she was saying now. Because, Robin was just very nasty in a sense. She just wasn't very nice in the way that she was talking about Karen and whatnot. And I totally saw why Karen reacted the way she reacted. Monique asked her, how are you doing? How are you going to get through it and whatnot? The rest were very judgmental. Robin was very judgmental, and she was basically attacking Karen and, trying to make her look bad. So I see what Karen was talking about. I really do see it now. All this has been put to rest. I see what she was talking about. So next, Giselle and Sherman are going on a picnic. I think Giselle really tries too hard. When the show aired in season one, I liked Giselle very much. She was my favorite girl, but I just can't stand Giselle. To me, Giselle is tries too hard. She always tries too hard. She's doing too much, and he's catty, like trying to be sexy, trying to be interesting. It doesn't seem like her. It seems very forced, very rehearsed, very pretendish. She's a bitch, okay? She's a real bitch, and sometimes she's just very fake. And I don't appreciate that. This whole Sherman scene disgusted me, you know. She's like, oh, I feel like there's a pink scene, you know. When the episode starts, she's like, he liked the way my booty was moving, like, I'm pepping right now, and I ain't using my hand. Like, Gerba, you ain't got no ass, Giselle. Okay, you ain't got no ass, girl. You might have assets in your house, but not assets behind you. You ain't got no ass, Giselle. What are you talking about? What is she talking about? Somebody tell me. Somebody tell me. What is Giselle talking about? Giselle don't have no ass, okay, people? Have you ever paid attention? That's like the first thing I noticed with the Potomac Wives, okay? You know, I watch Atlanta, and so when they came to Potomac, I was like, women ain't got no booty, you know? All the ass is flat, okay? You know, they try to say that Ashley has a nice ass. I'm like, rare. That shit don't look good. It doesn't. It's shaped really, really weird. None of them impressed me. I think Charisse has the best thing going on. But what booty, girl? Gerba. So Ashley is having a brunch over at Oz there. And, you know, the food looked nice. You know, it seemed like everyone was enjoying themselves. It looked less kangaroo-like. Okay, honey? The menu. You know, they had that change in menu. So I guess it's why it's less kangaroo-like, you know? And so Monique comes in. She has some nice, you know, cornrows. Looking good and stuff, you know. She has on a beautiful dress. I love, you know, it looks very breezy, very fun like and floral, and you know, just beautiful, you know. She looks very nice and collected, you know. So, you know, they're talking for a while, you know. She's introducing Monique to, you know, persons, and then we see this old girl comes walking across the street, hips soaring. You know, we find out this is the new girl. This is Candace. And, you know, they had Ashley in her little confessionals talking about how she knows Candace, how Candace was a pageant girl, and she was Miss United States 2013. Yeah, she was Miss United States 2013. And so, you know, Ashley even throwed a little shade there in the way that she said it, but like, girl, bye. Like, girl, bye. Girl, please. Like, you're introducing your friend, and you're already shading her. Oh, my God. What is that? But, you know, Candace comes in, and Candace seems to have a very bubbly personality. And I would expect that Monique and her would vibe, you know, excellently. Because, you know, Monique is very bubbly and fun and loose. Not too loose, but, you know, just down to earth to me. And so I expect her and Monique to really vibe. So, you know, Candace announces she's engaged, honey. And, you know, everyone is like, and she's like, huh, you're engaged? And she's like, yes. She's like, yes, I'm engaged. You know, they had a whole thing going on. And, you know, they're like, congratulations and all that. You know? Candace seems very nice, very bubbly or whatever, but it just seems like a fat bit, like, you know, she's trying too hard. You felt it? I felt it. Anyway, moving on. It's moving day at the Dixons, you know, Robin talking about, you know, she actually thought paying $4,000 to persons to move her stuff, you know, was normal, like. You know, when I look at Robin's back in the day pictures, you know, those throwback pictures, she don't look like she had money. So I don't know how this bitch could take it's normal for you to pay people to pack up your house so you can move and pay them $4,000. Like, you're tragging. She really doesn't look that way. Like, she was brought up like that. I could be wrong, but she doesn't look like she was brought up like that, that she would think that paying people $4,000 to move your stuff was normal, okay? So she starts talking about Ashley not knowing about being protective over, you know, her man or whatever, because she's never gone through the stuff that they've gone through, and how she'd been there when Juan didn't have money, and she was there when he had money, and she's known him for years, and she's born his child, and Ashley hasn't done any of these things. That's why she can be so judgmental and be so quick to say these things, because she doesn't know what it's like to be that. She don't know what it's like and what's not. I think it's some bullshit. I totally understand, you know, she started from the bottom with him. He's all she's accustomed to. But at the same time, you need to check in with reality at some point in time and realize that this is not right. This is not normal. And it might feel good to you now, but what will happen when you get older and then, you know, you realize that you really wasted this much time of your life? Who knows? Maybe things with Juan will never get better. He's not making any steps in the right direction to heal and mend the situation. You guys may never get back together. He might finally wake up a day and find someone that he's interested in and go and leave you. And now you're old, and you know, your excuses, oh, we have children together and this and that, and Ashley doesn't know this. What will happen when your children are gone and you are old and alone and the rain is falling outside? Hello? Have you thought of that? She needs to be very careful. I don't want to be too judgmental of her situation, but the way in which she is, you know, talking, Ashley doesn't know because she hasn't this and she married a man with money and this and that and all these things. It's kind of foolish. I understand the perspective from which Ashley's coming from. Well, maybe she's not coming from that, you know, perspective. Maybe she's just being a talkative biatch, okay? But I see what it could be, okay? I see the positive side to it. I see what can happen, and I think that Robin needs to be careful, okay? She just needs to be careful. You know, Karen is inviting everyone, all the ladies, to a press conference, okay? Now, Karen, what the? Like, Karen is ratchet these last, like, the ending of season 2 and this season. All the grand dame behavior is so gone. You know, she was like, oh, you don't behave like that in Potomac, and that's not the proper way, and ladies this and ladies that. And she is cussing left, right, and center. Karen is dragging wigs and pulling tails, and you know, she is ghetto, okay, honey? She's getting down, she's getting loose. And I think I like this more. It's more authentic. But at the same time, I need to get in her ass about her pretense in the beginning, because she was very pretensive, you know, acting like she's prim and proper, and I don't even slap a fly type of behavior, like, whatever. Guys, I apologize if I sound a bit hoarse. You know, this is my third video back to back, no break, so you know, my voice is a bit gone, you know, it's a bit gone, okay? It's going, you know, it's very grouchy, I would say. You know, so she's invited everyone to a press conference. She calls Robin, she calls Ashley, she calls Giselle, and she's telling them about it. Eventually, she would have called all the other ladies and what's not. So, Candace intro, you know, she introduces her husband, her soon-to-be husband, who she calls her husband. Yeah, that was another too much type of shit. I don't believe that bitch says that, okay? She just made that whole shit up. Just, you know, make herself more interesting on the show. I see what you're doing, honey, but whatever. You know? She lets us know that he's divorced with 3 kids and, you know, trying to give us basically the back history on him and what's not. You know, it's a little cutesy. Nothing interesting at all. So there it goes. Giselle. Giselle strikes again, like, this girl is getting on my nerve. Like, how several see Giselle? You are trying so hard to be the star of the show because you hated how Karen was acting like she's the star of the show. So now you're just going out of your wits, going to the ends of the earth to be the center of attraction and whatever. You want to be the star of the show. Have several seats, honey. I'm tired of this nonsense. This is foolishness with you needs to just stop. Just stop, Giselle. She wants to create t-shirts, you know, with the slogan, Free Uncle Ben. You know, she calls Karen's husband Uncle Ben and all this bullshit. Giselle have several seats, and Robin is like a goddamn minion. Like, Robin, get a brain of your own, okay? You're so silly when you're around Giselle. God damn it. It's like you're really seeing that Robin really doesn't have a brain. She doesn't have a brain when she's around Juan. And when it comes to Juan, and she doesn't have a brain when it comes to Giselle. She just can't tell her when she's wrong either. And it's just foolish. Like, bye, bye, Robin. Bye. You know, so they start, they're at this, you know, they come to the press conference, and, you know, the first thing happens, you know, Giselle walks in, and she's not wearing Free Uncle Ben. Instead, it was, praying for the Hugers, bitch, you just did that scene trying to get us attention, okay? You know your ass wasn't gonna wear that shit, okay? But I still, the praying for the Hugers is kind of acceptable, unless you know the type of shady bitch that Giselle really is. So she comes in, and they're all talking, and Karen begins to talk about this whole thing, and you know how the, whatever the name of the paper is that, you know, released the information, Washington something is the name, I believe, yeah, Washington Post or something like that to call it, you know, talking about the whole situation when it was announced there, you know, she saw friends being Giselle, you know, going up on social media and posting all kinds of negative things and laughing at her, making fun of her. And that was very nasty of Giselle. Giselle is a shady bitch. Her attitude is that of a bitch. Okay, a bitch. I would never be friends with Giselle. Giselle is just not trustable. She's ridiculous. I don't like Giselle anymore, okay, people? Giselle is horrible. She's a terrible person for you to go up there and post these things about someone that you knew for well over 10 years and say that you're such good friends with and whatnot. And you're just being ridiculous, okay, Giselle? We just don't care for you on this ship. You're shitty, okay? This is a shitty type of move. This is low, honey, low. You're not a friend, Giselle. You're just trying hard to be the center of attraction on the show and for people to be, you know, all over you and this shit. Giselle, I'm so tired of you, you know? And she tries to clear it up by saying, oh, I didn't post that. I just retweeted something that the shade room said. Bitch, you were forwarding the room, okay? You were forwarding the problem. You were throwing fuel on the fire, Giselle. Why can't you see the shit that you do? Giselle is really working my nerve this season, and it just started. I'm sick of Giselle, okay? I'm sick of her. And the thing is, she looks like the oldest housewife, okay? Just that bitch of her, and her black is cracking, okay? That shit is cracked up, okay? She looks horrible. She looks tired all, you know, her neck, especially last season. It seems like she went and got some work done. It's a little bit smoother. But Giselle, every time that camera goes up on her, she looks creaked and cracked and tired and worn out and ugh. Girl, bye, okay? Bye. You ought not to be talking about these other ladies because you are so ratchet. And you're no better at, with any other things that she talk about the other housewives do it. She is 10 times worse, okay? Like, bye, Giselle. I'm not here for you on this shit. I must say, I am disgusted by Karen's wig. She had on, like, two wigs in this episode that was just trashy. It was just ridiculous. It was, Karen. Don't be a charade, honey. Don't be a charade with you. Don't be a Nene Leaks. Get yourself together. Get you a new glam squad or whatever it is you need to do. It just wasn't looking good, okay? You know, actually asked Karen if she's being indicted, and Karen takes that little evil laugh, you know. You know, she takes that little evil laugh, and then she went off on Ashley, and Ashley is a nosy bitch, okay? Like, Ashley And Giselle and Robin are my least favorite persons on the show. Originally, I couldn't take Sheree and Karen, but you know, these ladies are getting very irritating, you know? They're so silly, you know? Sometimes I just can't take it, you know? They're all trying way too much. I don't think Robin is really trying, but she's too gullible and too controllable. Giselle is a bitch, a real bitch that wants attention. And Ashley is a nosy bitch, okay? A nosy bitch that just don't know her role, okay? So, you know, Karen goes off on her ass and says, did Michael get indicted for swinging his ding-a-ling across Instagram, honey? And so I went to actually check for this stuff and I saw a picture, a still shot of the video. I didn't see, you know, the actual video. You know, Michael is very loose, you know? Makes me wonder, the two of them are just a little too kinky for, you know, my likeness, but you know. Do your thing, people. Do your thing, girl. Do your thing, Michael. Whatever. If you like it, I love him. Whatever. But he's a just. My truth is really doing bad, okay? You know, if she likes it, great for her. Great for him. Great for you guys. But Michael is just too loose. But you know, Ashley couldn't take what she said. And she's like, that wasn't in the Washington Post. That was it. And last night, and they started going back and forth. And Karen started cussing the hell out of Ashley. And there was a lot of finger pointing and a loudness. And Karen gets up and goes to walk out. You know, Karen basically told her, turns out Ashley's husband is out meeting women in London, and you know, that was in the Shade Room or some one of these blogging websites, you know, posted that little blog about Ashley's husband, Michael, up in London, getting some tail, honey, okay? He was out there looking for women or whatever it is. Ashley has a really big forehead, okay? I don't know. I'm wrong for this, but you know, I've just seen that seed in my head right now, and all I can think is Ashley has a big forehead. Like, y'all can say what y'all want about Rihanna, she is not on Ashley's level, okay? Ashley has a really big forehead, and it calls my attention every single time I see her, and she's wearing her hair in a certain manner, she pulls her hair back. You know, it really calls my attention. She has a big forehead, okay? Like, Karen Johnson, mind your business, you know? Karen really cussed the hell out of Ashley, and she was losing it, and she was about to walk out. You know, Robin said, you're the one who called us here for a press conference. How you gonna just walk out of it and what's not? So, you know, Karen sits down, and they try to finish the talk, but this whole blow-up that happened, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. I think Karen shouldn't have given these ladies the time of day. She knows they weren't here for her. She knows that Giselle is shit. She knows that Ashley is just a nosy trick. She knows that Robin is a brainless bitch. So, like, whatever. These ladies are really irritating me, and this is only episode 2. I just Potomac women really get on my nerve, okay? But nevertheless, sometimes it can be quite entertaining, don't get me wrong, but this episode really didn't give me much. It just kept me very irritated at the way, you know, Giselle was behaving, and it really showed up some more of you know, Robin's brainless behavior, and Ashley's just being a nosy bitch again. The new girl comes on, she's trying a little too hard. Take it back a little, Candace, take it back a little. You know, she's cute and what's not. Seems like she'll be good company for Monique if Monique doesn't try to be a grand dame. You know, comes with this, you know, this whole charade that this whole front that ladies were trying to put on when the show first aired, like they're so classy and what's not. You know, once she doesn't try to do that, try to be a Giselle, you know, all will be well and they'll be great friends, in my opinion. So that's it for Real Housewives of Potomac. I'm so glad I'm done. Like, my throat is really dry, and it's just it's just not working out, honey. I'm getting hoarse, you know. But thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you so much for being here. Ensure you like and subscribe. Come on, people, like and subscribe. Thank you so much for being here. I love you for watching. Bye.